Hi, and welcome to your Search Ads 360 Fundamentals training series. In this video, you'll learn how to navigate Search Ads 360. Before we dive into the platform, let's talk about the hierarchy on which SA360 functions. That hierarchy looks like this. Now, if you've used SA360 for a while, you'll need to adopt some new terminology. The top tiers of the SA360 hierarchy have been completely renamed. Agency accounts are now called manager accounts. Advertiser accounts are now referred to as sub-manager accounts. Engine accounts are now client accounts. And engine types are account types in the new SA360 experience. So let's look at the new hierarchy. At the top is the manager level. This is the agency or business that is managing this SA360 account. Under that, we have sub-managers, which equate to advertisers. For agencies, these might be individual clients. For direct marketers, these could represent your brands or business units. Below sub-managers, we have client accounts. These represent the search engines through which you're advertising, like Google Ads or Microsoft Advertising. The top two levels of the hierarchy are created in SA360. Client accounts can be linked and managed within SA360. The levels beneath client accounts, including campaigns, ad groups, keywords, etc., will be pulled into SA360 after the client account is synced. You'll then be able to manage your search engine accounts with SA360. Now that you know the SA360 hierarchy, let's jump into the platform and poke around a bit. When you log into SA360, your user type and permissions will determine whether you land in a manager or sub-manager account. In my case, I land in the Adswerve Manager account, but I'll go ahead and open a sub-manager account by clicking the Manager drop-down menu and choosing a sub-manager from the provided list. You'll be able to tell which account you land in by viewing the Manager and Sub-Manager fields in your top toolbar. These fields allow you to navigate among different manager, sub-manager, and client accounts in your SA360 hierarchy. Your view will default to the Overview tab, which we see here. This tab provides an overview of all client accounts nested within your manager or sub-manager. Since we're on the Overview tab, let's look at the left panel. The next tab is the Experience Hub. You do have to open a sub-manager account for the Experience Hub to be useful. This tab shows you the fun new things that are happening in SA360, like new features, items that can now be migrated to the new UI, and sync errors. Okay, that last one's not so fun, but you get the idea. The Experience Hub is SA360's version of headlines for the selected sub-manager. Note that new features and FAQs are listed in the Feature Status tab at the top of this page. Next in the left panel is Recommendations. Once live, the Recommendations page will automatically generate suggestions that could improve your overall performance based on your account's performance history, your campaign settings, and trends across search ads. The next 8 tabs, Accounts, Campaigns, Ad Groups, Product Groups, Performance Center, Ads, Keywords, and Audience, provide respective aggregated data regarding the manager or sub-manager account you're viewing. The Content tab lets you select keyword exclusions for display and video, and the Settings tab allows you to edit the settings at different levels of your SA360 hierarchy. Now let's move our attention to the toolbar in the top right-hand corner of the page. On the far right is your user profile, where you can navigate between the SA360 manager accounts you have access to. To the left of that is the GMP Launchpad, where you can navigate to other GMP products like Campaign Manager 360, Display and Video 360, and more. The bell to the left of the GMP Launchpad displays notifications related to your account. To the left of that is the Help icon, where you can browse the Help Center for SA360. Be aware that the legacy SA360 Help Center operates on a completely separate portal than the new SA360 Help Center. So if you need to reference an article about the legacy SA360 experience, click this Help icon, then click Open the previous SA360 experience, and access the Help Center from that view. Further to the left is the Refresh button that, when clicked, refreshes the data in your current view. Next on the left is the Tools and Settings button, where you can access a number of features that we will explore in future videos. And finally, the Reports button provides access to several reporting tools. These tools are almost identical to Google Ads reporting tools, except that the executive reporting option has been replaced with this predefined reports option. So that's the lay of the land. Continue to the next video to learn how to create sub-managers in SA360.